Good afternoon to all of you. And thank you for coming. This is something we have just put together. I have what I call the Praise Trilogy. It's three songs that offer praise to God who gives us everything. And this is where I want to start with this Praise Trilogy. Everybody up here is not even on purpose. They're just not drafted to come over here. But they're going to help out.
Praise is what I do. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come now in the matchless name of Jesus, God. We come thanking you, God, because when we look back over our lives, we see how far you have brought us. And for that, we just say thank you, Lord. God, we realize we wouldn't be who we are, doing what we're doing, and have what we have if it had not been for you. God, thank you, God, for over 200 years ago. God, look how far you brought us from a mighty long way. And so today, God, we just want to celebrate today through songs, God, through the instruments, God. Use those that have come today to lift you up, God. God, thank you for another opportunity to praise you, God. Thank you, God, that you are total praise. Thank you, God, that everything we need is in you. So, God, we ask you right now to stop by Reading Chapel today as we celebrate our Heritage Day, God, as we celebrate all of these wonderful singers and all of these musicians that have come by, God, to just be used by you. So, God, I pray that you will have your way in this place. I pray, God, that somebody that came by today, maybe for their first time, God, will be rejuvenated. We'll see exactly, God, how good you are and what you can do, God. We pray now, God, that your Holy Spirit will move in this place right now, God. God, we thank you because we've come this far by faith, God. And through the ups and the downs and the end times and the out times, God, you still stay with us and you are with us right now. So have your way in this service right now, God. God, do what you do best, God, and let's bless the people of God. Thank you, God, for all of those that have come by today. We pray, God, that those that are on their way, God, that you will speak up their step, because I believe in the name of Jesus that we're going to have a hallelujah good time in here today. And so, God, just let your will be done in this place. Thank you, God, for Sister Isola Collins, God, who worked hard, God, and put this program together, God. We ask for a special blessing upon her, God. We pray, God, that every one of us, God, leave here, God, with a renewed and regenerated spirit, God. Lord, now have your way in this place. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Be so slow. I would like to first of all thank every one of you for having come out, because in this 1 month when we celebrate Heritage, we're all Americans. I like some things I say to people sometimes I'm afraid of what I see, but someone did write well that we're all Americans. We all need to know our history, which includes African Americans. Today, I'm just trying to carry on something that we started about 40 years ago. It's Brittany Hightower and myself, but we were part of a music club that had each month two people who would present the program. And when it came out time, we could only do African Americans in the club. We always took February so we could use it as an excuse to let everybody know what happened with the music. A lot of people know about spirituals, which our choir does, the Heritage Choir, Heritage Crawl. And a lot of people know about jazz and blues, which we're going to play today too. But we don't know a lot about the art songs and the songs which have been written by African Americans that speak to a little more sophisticated type of music. And so we went through, as I said, about 40 years now, until she passed away, doing that, at least introducing people to that. And I want to just, part of my personal privilege of saying that a person, another person who's passed away, was my twin. I called her Florence Crim Robinson. She was the dean and finally the author of arts and sciences of Clark Atlanta University, and she knew personally many of these people who wrote manuscripts that didn't get published. And so a lot of music we don't hear anymore has been forgotten. A lot has been published now. I'm proud of that my day has been published. Without further ado, I just want to just present these people who have come at my request to give you their versions of what African American composers and arrangers have done. They will tell you something about those composers. And first, Mr. Gary Navy.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
So, can you hear me?
Yes.
So, my first piece, For You There Is No Song, was composed by Leslie Adams. Leslie Adams was born December 20th, 1932, in Cleveland, Ohio. Harrison Leslie Adams earned a bachelor's from Oberlin Conservatory, master's from Cal State University, Long Beach, and a PhD in music composition from Ohio State University. He has received numerous awards for composition, including the National Association of Negro Women's Award and the Christian Arts Annual Competition for Choral Music. Mr. Adams has composed symphonies, choral works, and he also even composed an opera called Blake. I'm now going to sing, as I said before, For You, There Is No Song, from the collection called Anthology of Art Songs by Black American Composers. First, I should have introduced before I had to say it was my accompanist. I know it says that that Mom, Valencia Arsenal, is going to be my accompanist, but not today. Unfortunately, we're not going to get a chance to work together again. But my accompanist today is actually Audrey Dale. And Audrey and I met when I was working at St. Mary Magdalene Catholic Church in Humble, Texas. The next song, his name's so sweet, when I decided I wanted to do that, I said, but I don't want to do the Hall Johnson arrangement of his name so sweet. But, see, that may have been a mistake. But it was kind of hard to find different arrangements. But, you know, I was talking about encounters. I was talking to Barbara Tucker, which is definitely a friend of Reedy Chapel, and many of you know, and she's saying, you know, Gwen Hurley wrote a piece that actually was arranged for voice and choir. And I said, well, let me look at it and see what I can do with it. But we're only going to do part of Lynn's arrangement of his name, so sweet. Of course, it would be the only bio I left on my desk at work, but so I do have some of the notes. Glenn was born in July 5th, 1949 in Guthrie, Oklahoma, and passed away since December 7th, 2007. It's hard to believe it's been since 2007. It doesn't seem like it was that long ago. But I spoke about encounters. I was privileged to work with Glenn because of Barbara Tucker. When he was from Oklahoma, but at one point in his time, he was actually, stationed or in Houston at Good Hope Baptist Church, and that's when, I guess, Barbara and Glenn first met. And many of you know the song, Order My Steps, and that was one of the first things they did in collaborations that they've done. Actually, this song, he actually arranged for Barbara for a choir that they worked with in Arkansas when they go down there from time to time. So, Lynn Everett Burley basically was a pianist, composer, and arranger, composer of many styles, jazz, gospel, also arranged many spirituals. He also wrote an oratorio. I know a lot of it was patterned after the Messiah, but he wrote Born to Die. So if you ever have an opportunity, I think it was performed in Galveston back in December, I believe. But if you ever have a chance to hear Glenn's Born to Die, it's a beautiful work that shows of some of the things that he did. He's in Washington, D.C. at a national conference for Catholic musicians, and there was Glenn. There he was always looking at doing different things, and one of the things we spoke that evening at the conference, he wanted to compose a mass for the Catholic Church. And I don't know if he ever completed that, but the thing that his colleagues were saying, there's lots of manuscripts over here that his sister and them have, and some haven't published and some haven't. So now, His Name's So Sweet by Glenn Edward Burley. So sweet.
Just come from the fountain, Lord. Just come from the fountain. So you guys heard she called it experience. She didn't call it old, she called it experience.
That's me.
Well, you know, Albert, I tell you what, it's tough going after acting like that. Wouldn't be wonderful, Glenn? The two art songs that I'm singing today are from a whole collection of songs. The names of them are Standing in the Need of Prayer and Go Down Moses. They were both written by the name Henry Thatcher Burley, not to be confused with Glenn Burley. but his name was Henry Thatcher Burley. And right, he's not an American household name when you think about that, but his work was very important. because he was one of the first composers of African-American descent to start writing down the spirituals. And so his work was monumental when you think about it in that way. He was born December 2nd, 1886, in Erie, Pennsylvania, 1 year out of slavery. And his grandfather used to sing the spirituals to him when he grew up. And he grew up singing those songs. And eventually, he started developing his musical prowess. He graduated from the National Conservatory of Music. And then as he graduated, he started composing and writing and arranging spirituals. And as I said, he was one of the first. There were others, but he was one of the first that began to write down what his grandfather had said. And he did it in the form called the Art Song. And the Art Song is, and so that's why that's very important. Because of that, we do have a record of some of those spirituals, and that's very precious because in days like this, these things can just be, you know, forgotten about and you never hear these again. But Mr. Burley sat down and wrote them, and that was a very good thing to do. So today, our first song, I think you have it, Standing in the Need of Prayer. And we're going to do that, and then go on to the Golden Pages.
I'll see.
do something else, baby. Mr. Harold Love Jr.
Started playing guitar, bass, and piano, and then I started to sing a lot. So
myself thus far. And you have a wonderful time. I tell you, this is Sunday's best right here. All right. I mean, we don't have church praise and all of them here, but we got Sunday's best right here today. Let's give all of these arts on hand. Everybody's been sitting for a while. So what we're going to ask you to do is just come around and drop your offering so you can get a little stretch. I could just pass it, but then you won't get the exercise that you need. And so we want you to bring your offering and be a blessing to the body of Christ. So we're going to ask that whatever the Lord puts on your heart, amen, that you will come. And if you're going to write a check, make sure you write it out to Reedy Chapel, A.M., Church. Amen. Reading Chapel. R-E-E-D-Y. Reading Chapel. Don't forget the Y. Because if you would read, that's me. That's the reading. Amen. If you don't put the Y, I will take it and I will catch it. Amen. But we wanted to go to Reading Chapel. Amen. So we're going to ask Danny, she would give us some moving music, some giving music. Amen. That we will stand on both sides.
Here, lady, I don't get in trouble if I
program or something. That's okay, because it'd be very, I mean, it's an honor that Mrs. Collins has asked me to sing one of her original compositions, but it's also very nervous when the composer sitting right there. But it's a part of what I said, I'm talking about encounters, and may have to correct me. I mean, I grew up in Lamarck, and so Galveston was, you know, even in choir, you know, we still had rivals, you know. So, but I think you could not have heard about, you know, some of the greats of Galveston. They worked in music, whether it was Mrs. Collins, or Mrs. Hightower, Leonard Gilbert, and so. And eventually, you got a chance to. Work with all of them, but I believe it was, kind of forgot to mention, the song for you there is, the song I did earlier, For You There Are No Tears, was actually given to me by Hope Scheiber when I was a voice teacher at College of the Mainland, but I believe it's through the Mainland Chorale, the Hope's record, that I first actually met Mrs. Collins, and then that, I guess, relationship began from then, and it's been an honor, and I've learned so much over the years. So, without any further ado, like I said, it's going to seem deep on these things. Again, that's one of my favorite books of the Bible as well. So, I guess also it's an honor because she actually wrote it for her son, Roy Collins III, and again, to trust me with it, Roy being a wonderful performer and singer. So, I hope I'll do the song justice.
I hope your accompanist does the song justice.
much change. And as I said, there is still a little connection there with being much change. Bernard Inyer, if I'm saying that correctly, was born in Houston, Texas. So see, there's our connection. We have two Texas African-American composers, Ms. Collins and Mr. Inyer. He was born in on January 18th, 1945. He graduated from Jack Yates High School in 1962. After graduating, his family moved to San Diego, along with composing and arranging songs. Bernard also plays several instruments: piano, guitar, bass, drums, flugelhorn, alto sax, alto and soprano sax, and the flute. So while he was living in San Diego in 1965, he met Dizzy Gillespie, thank you very much, when that was when his musical career began. Now this is Everything Must Change. Thank you.
audience knows, I don't like for her to say that at all. Aaron, you were the experienced one. I'm the old one. I have been singing for many, many, many years, and I'm on the wane now. So anything that comes out is a blessing from God. Amen. The first number I'll be doing is the Negro Spirit. It's called Stand Still Joy. The composer I know, but it is arranged by H.T. Burke. Aaron is always ready to give you his biography and interesting information, so I will not repeat. So we'll just go right into Stand Still Joy.
Thank you. next song is called Joy. It's spiritual, written by Edwin Hawkins. I think that album came out in the late 1960s. The song that you would remember on that was the Joy is on that album, but the song that is better known than Joy. Oh, happy day. It's that age. Edwin Hawkins still lives, still performs, still is writing. He and his family, he did lose his brother several years ago. But Edwin is still going strong. This is Joy.
Behind. It's such an honor to be in the presence of a sage like Miss Collins, who has put this all together. Isaiah, okay? And over there on the piano, we have Miss Kiara, who is
and turn to page 448. If you have a hymnal, just get to put the instruments up. Thank you so much. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Ms. Collins personally for starting that music club. On Saturday, we have three young people that will be competing at the Gold Cup. And this is the way we start, and this is the way we get to be proficient, and we get to be professional, and we get to be musicians. This song that I'm going to play for you is entitled, do you have it? What's it entitled? Okay, and so it's about a young man, his name was Mr. Horatio, who lost his family in a tragic, I think it was a ship. He lost his daughter, his son, and his wife. And so he sat down and he wrote these words, and I want you to just follow them, because the Lord did bless me with a voice. So just follow them as I play for you "When Peace Like a River."
Singing folk music,
has joined me with singing some ballads. I tell you a lot more about her. It's getting late, but she's on national TV sometimes. She's been on Ashton Fair. Some of you may have seen the PBS special. And I'm just going to go on quickly and say that with her, this young man that I showed you recently, today, playing piano, has come on playing bass guitar. And I said, well, you know, just kind of have a bass player. These people. And I think a lot of these folks, anyway, we have some potential. We're just getting started. We want you to hear, first of all, Duke Ellington's Sack Doll, and then I want you to hear Denise Frankie singing that Shadow Your Smile, which was written by Paul Webster, lyricist for Shadow, and filmed at that time in 1965, and won the Grammy Award Song of the Year. He's by John Mandel, I break that down. And then she'll finish with my blues, which I wrote a long time ago. And I was going back and forth from the job. So, would you all please come? Thank you.
head for the blues.
Today with all of these wonderful musicians, even our young babies. Let's give them a hand. Awesome. Amen. And I thank God for you, my sister, that's working with them. And I'm telling you, Maestro on that piano yourself. Amen. I'm telling you, God is just good. God bless you. All of the wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. I don't want to call it a name because I forget. But let me tell you, everybody that performed today, would you just stand wherever you are, if you were a performer, let's give them. Come on. Again, we thank God for Sister Collins. Amen. Let's give her another hand. And I like that freestyle. You say, well, we didn't really practice. We just got together. And I hate to see you when you practice. Amen. And so I'm so grateful I see a video up there. Alright, so y'all, this is going to be good. They got a video of everything that was done. We thank God for all of the singers, all of the musicians, and we thank God for each and every one of you all that came back and stayed. I know you enjoyed yourself. I did, amen. From the beginning all the way to the end. And y'all surprised me at the end, though. I'm just ready to go and turn my music off. Amen. That was real good. That was real good. But that just let you know that how much talent, how much God has gifted so many wonderful people. Amen. And that we're just grateful today that we have an opportunity to hear them. And I'm praying that they will be back. Amen. They'll come back and bless us again at another time. We just celebrated last week Miss Izola Collins Heritage. We call her the legacy of icon of our church. And last week we celebrated her. Last week we honored her. Again, let's give her a hand. For Reedy Chapel, but the community as well. And I can tell by all of you that are here that you are great friends of her and that you all work together. And I know that things, you know, are just awesome when you all get together. So you're going to have to include Pastor on some of your travels. Amen. Because y'all got it going on. Amen. I mean, y'all just wave your hand in the air like you just don't care. Wobble and do all that stuff too. Amen. Don't hold back. Just let me know. Amen. I just keep it real. Amen. Ain't nothing like keeping it real. Isn't that right? You live longer if you keep it real, won't you? Amen. God is good. We thank God again for you. And I noticed that on our program that there are books over in the fellowship hall, and their CDs as well by Ms. Collins. So please stop by the fellowship hall next door and look at the books, the CDs, and purchase some. I know that it will be worth your while. Again, I say thank you for coming out this evening. Those that didn't make it, they missed the treat. Wouldn't you say so? Wouldn't you say so? Amen. Again, we invite you to come back and fellowship with us at any time. There is a video going on, so I don't know if they're sending the videos or not, you know, but yeah, all right, so I'm just throwing that in case, you know.
Yeah, a little advertisement. But we thank God again for you. Rita Chapel, love you, and you're always welcome to come back in our sanctuary and praise God with us. I think that is it. We thank you again for your offering. We thank you for being here on time. We started at 3, and it was a wonderful, wonderful program. Ms. Collins, do you have any remarks that you would like to make?
Just take a collection because these people come free. And
yeah.
I'm just ashamed of the fact that so many times they come free. They should have just taken a lot more money.
Yeah.
But I really appreciate all of you coming.
Amen. Let's give them another hand. Amen. I think that's about it. We'll be celebrating our Heritage Day on next Sunday. We will have a soul food dinner next door. And if you finish singing and performing or whatever, just slide by. And we're going to have some greens and some cabbage and some poke bones and some all those kind of balls and chicken and everything. So I'm inviting you all to come back and celebrate with us on next Sunday. Amen?
Amen?
Amen? Is that all right? Amen. All right, let us stand. If you will come and pray the benediction for us. We thank God again for
pray God for blessings.
We thank God again for Rita Chapel that's in the house. We thank God for all our visitors. And again, God bless you and God keep you for coming out to celebrate with us. Enjoy your presence. Come on, grab somebody else.